Hello, my name is Daniel Krachun. I'm the head of marketing at Nihedonia. I'm here with John McVeigh, the CEO of Nihedonia Limited Company. So I would like to ask you several questions then. The first one would be, could you describe the background of Nihedonia Limited?
Well, Nihedonia was established quite recently, just 3 years ago, back in 2015. I'd been working at the international law firm DLA Piper in St. Petersburg in Russia, and I'd been with them for a good 8 years. And what I noticed when I was in DLA Piper, that although it's possible to find wonderfully talented lawyers and partners with great legal expertise, it wasn't easy to find rainmakers, to find those lawyers who really knew how to find clients, generate work, and to bring in the revenues. And quite often this wasn't a problem for the lawyers, at least, until they wished to become partners. And when they wanted to take a more senior position, when they wanted to have their own department, or even if they wanted to leave and make their own law firm, then it became a problem that, you know, you need to be able to find revenues to generate work, not only rely on the quality of your legal expertise.
So that's great. And why are the Nihedonia services needed?
Well, Nihedonia services are needed because the legal environment changes. You can no longer simply have a good name and a good company and expect to work to drop from the sky. You might be in Legal 500 and Chambers, these different rating agencies. You might have a wonderful website. But if the economy goes down, or if there's massive competition and increasing competition, then you're going to find your firm coming under price pressure. Clients become more sophisticated. They move away quite often from the billable hour system, and they want fixed rates, they want fee caps, and very often there's a greater trend in moving towards RFPs, request for proposal. So the clients, they have a stronger position. They can, you know, they can do tenders and then decide on the cheapest provider. It becomes very difficult.
Sounds interesting. And how do you help the law firms?
Well, I used to think this was just a problem of the Russian legal education system, but it turns out it's not. It's a problem in every single country. That the lawyers simply quite often have never studied legal sales, legal marketing. They don't have these skills. So what I do is I come to the law firms once a month, once every couple of months, and we do a face-to-face training. And this is just 3 hours in duration, sometimes 4 hours. And we do a topic like sales networking or pitching or cross-selling. We do these different topics. It's an interactive session. It's not a lecture. That would be terribly boring. You know, it's an interactive session. And we try and step-by-step build up these skills. Sometimes I do a full-day event with a group of partners. But to be honest, a systematic approach over a number of months is much better. It takes time for people to change behaviors and adopt these kind of skills. So if you do a session or a series of sessions over 6 months to a year, then after that, your team, the partners, the lawyers are much more commercially astute, much more confident, and much more able to generate work for the firm.
Marvelous. And could you describe, please, the easy wins for law firms to increase their revenue?
And that's the amazing thing, because I've met now just under 300 law firms across 60 countries. What I see is that they're basically making the same kind of mistakes, and they're missing the same opportunities. There is not one law firm that I've met yet which is systematic and brilliant in cross-selling. And of course, I think many of the managing partners will agree with me that cross-selling is a huge opportunity for law firms. But none of them, as far as I see, none of them are doing cross-sell meetings. None of them are applying the instruments of cross-selling, such as coin analysis, ABC analysis. You know, there's a lot of different instruments which we could use and apply in a systematic approach, and that in itself would increase client retention, consolidate our position and revenues. To be honest, you know, a lot of the things that we can do are relatively simple, easy wins. Do we have business development plans? Are we doing business development meetings? Do we have a consultative selling methodology that we use in our prospect meetings with potential clients for the firm? Quite often the answer is no. So I can help show the easy wins. We apply these meeting by meeting. And quite often the results are spectacular.
Okay, and let's talk about Nihedonia Concept Cards project. It's a new marketing project. Describe it, please.
Yeah, I'm quite excited about this project because what I noticed was that when I was researching, and for years and years I bought lots of different books on legal sales and marketing, when I was researching the best ideas, the best concepts to put into Nicodonia material, I found that a book itself would be maybe 90%, 95%, I would call it fluff. If you pull out the key ideas from that book and you put them on paper, quite often you could write it on one page or on a postcard even. So I was thinking a good idea would be, how about we take the key concepts, all of the good bits, the key instruments, from each of the topics which we have. So we have 8 main topics. Put them onto flashcards. One side of the card is a visual representation of the concept, and the other side a written description of the concept. And then by playing with these cards, you can associate the visual pictogram with the concept itself. I started trying this with some of our law firms in Kiev and Budapest and Zagreb, and the results were quite promising. And not only did it help to retain the concepts into long-term memory, but it turned out actually to be quite fun. You know, you can do this as an activity, or you can do it individually, or as a group. So these concept cards, they're going to be on sale from our website and in Amazon, and I think they're something different, something new for the market. Definitely different from another book on sales and marketing.
I'm pretty sure that the majority of our viewers will be interested in Nicodonia Assistance. So what are the next steps?
Well, the next step, quite simply, is to drop us an email. My email is john@nicodonia.com. And then next time I'm in the jurisdiction, then I can drop in and have a coffee, have a chat, and get acquainted, and we can see how we can cooperate. Since I'm working across all of the countries of Europe each couple of months, then inevitably I'll be nearby at some time in the future, so we can just have a meeting and then decide on the next steps.
That was really interesting. Thanks again for coming.
My pleasure, Daniel. Thank you.
Thank you.
Bye.